Today I'm going to show you guys how you can mirror your laptop or your PC directly onto your HDTV wirelessly. Okay, now just to start, like if you guys have a newer computer or PC, typically you will have a WiDi already. It's WiDi compatible already. Basically, it's a wireless display. And if you have a newer HDTV as well, it may be Miracast enabled. If it is, you don't need no device or anything. You can directly connect your laptop or your computer to your HDTV wirelessly. This way you can watch Netflix, movies, YouTube, pretty much anything that you want to duplicate from your laptop onto your HDTV wirelessly. Now, most of you probably have a laptop that is WiDi compatible. And for you guys that are not sure if your computer is WiDi compatible, I'm going to put a link in the description below. I'm going to give you a tool. It's called the Intel WiDi compatibility tool, and it'll tell you. Like I just ran it on my PC here, and it does say your system supports wireless screen sharing using Miracast. So perfect. The only issue I have is my Sony HDTV. Is not Miracast compatible, so what I have to do is get a device, a receiver, and it's called Screen Beam Mini 2. It's a wireless display receiver, wireless display, basically WiDi, and it's by Action Tech. So I had to hook this up to my HDTV through the HDMI port, and I'll show you what that looks like in a second. And I got that on Amazon. I'll put a link below where I got that as well. And I am running Windows 8.1 on my computer. And what I can do from here is I can duplicate the screen. So both of the screen, the screens from my my laptop as well, my HDTV is the same thing, guys. And you can see, what I can do is if I hold down my Windows key and I'm gonna push the letter P, I'm gonna go in here. I can go ahead and also extend my monitor as well. So if I click on that. Now, if you take a look at this, what I can do is move this, check that out, all the way over just like that. See? And another thing is too, again, if I hold down the Windows key button and push the letter P for project here, I can also do screen only. So if I do that, then basically I'm just using my HDTV as my main monitor. Let me go ahead and push Windows key and the letter P again, and let me just go to duplicate, and let me just go to a YouTube video here, guys, and I'll show you. Let me just go here. And boom.
You guys have your iPhone, whether it's 4 or 5.
Now see, the sound is coming directly from my HDTV as well, guys.
Maybe you don't have all these options down here, guys.
So watching Netflix, whatever on here, I mean, it's really convenient.
Maybe it's showing.
You know, another good thing is too, you know, I mean, it's basically, this wireless display basically is just like having a HDMI cable, like this for instance. But the only thing is, you know, you're not gonna have like a plug that's always stuck into your laptop. And if you need to go distance, like I can go like 25 feet with this and there's no problem. It's still going to work wirelessly onto my HDTV. And especially if you're in bed, like watching TV or, you know, watching a movie or something like that, and your laptop's like always moving, you don't want that HDMI cable like in your, like bending your ports and stuff like that. So, but let me go ahead and go a little bit more in detail. Let me show you exactly what the receiver looks like. Now, the thing is, if your laptop or your PC is not WiDi compatible, you need to buy a receiver as well as a transmitter, and I'll have that in the below link where you guys can get that as well. Okay, so the only thing I had hooked up was this in the back of my HDTV. This is basically the receiver. So this right here goes into my HDMI port, and this USB plug here, you need this plugged in because this basically is going to power this, guys. So you have, if you have a USB port on the back of your TV, you can plug that in there for power, or you can plug it into your computer or anywhere where there's a USB port. But also in the box that comes with a wall adapter as well, so you can plug into the wall if need be. So again, this right here is called the Screen Beam Mini 2. It's by Action Tech. It's WiDi. WiDi stands for Wireless Display Receiver. Now, if your HDTV is Miracast compatible, then you don't need this. But it's the Miracast compatible TVs are usually the newer ones, the newer HDTVs. A lot of the Samsungs, LG have it. Another cool thing about this, the box that it came in, it did come with an extender, just to let you guys know. So basically, you know, sometimes it's really hard to get to the HDMI port in the back of your TV. So with this extender, what this does is you basically pop it into your HDMI, and then you always leave this cable in there. And anytime you want to connect this or another device, it just basically gives you more leeway, be easier to access. Okay, I'm going to show you how I hook it up. So I'm going to grab my receiver here. I'm going to hook it up into my HDMI port. I have several of them here. Not sure if you guys can see that, but let me just pop that in here. And then I'm going to plug, I have a USB, and I have a USB port up here that's available too for power. So I'm just going to plug that in right here. Okay, now I just plugged it in, and let me get my remote here, because obviously what you guys are gonna have to do is go into input, go to input, and then see the it was plugged in the HDMI, so find the one that's highlighted, like right there, so it would be on HDMI number 3. The system is loading, and let me show you what I have to do to, now it says ready to connect. Okay, so now what I have to do to connect it to my computer is, and this is a Windows 8.1, guys, so I'm going to go ahead and click on here and click on the search, and I'm just going to look for device, just like this, and click on where it says device settings. Click on device settings. So if this is your first time installing, you would click on add a device, but I already have mine in here. So let me just go ahead and just remove this. I'm going to go ahead and remove this. Are you sure you want to remove it? I'm going to click on yes, and you can see that. Okay, so I'm just going to go ahead and go to add a device now. Let it search, and you can see the SBWD, and it matches the TV, where it says receiver name. So I'm gonna go ahead and click on it. And now it is connecting. And voila. Okay, I think that's pretty much it, but I forgot to mention like one thing I thought it was pretty cool, but this cool device, guys, I'm able to hook up my Samsung Galaxy S3, S4, S5, S6 directly onto my HDTV as well, so I can watch my Netflix and play my games on my HDTV. So that's pretty much it. If you guys have questions or anything, just comment below. Thanks.